Hi everybody. I have a project that's going to require some iron acetate. So I'm going to make my own, and this is how I'm going to do it. I have my distilled vinegar here. I have my steel wool here. I do have a little cup here because I'm going to use the containers that the vinegar came in to do the actual reaction. So what I'm going to do is open up my white vinegar and pour off about 4 ounces out of each gallon. So that's 128 ounces. Subtracting the 4 ounces, that's going to give us 124 ounces of vinegar that one pad is going to react with. So I pour off this. I know this is a 9 ounce cup, so I'm going to take about half of it out. So I should have two relatively equal volumes of iron acetate. If I don't, I can just add a little bit back on this guy here. And that should be it. Now, the precise measurements can be important, but I make mine the same all the time. So I have my steel wool, which I have used 4-0 steel wool. It's super fine. So that means that there's a lot of surface area for the steel wool to react with. I also have washed it previously with some lacquer thinner and let it dry out so that there's no oils or anything from manufacturing of the steel wool getting involved in my solution. So it's about 7:15 right now, and it's going to sit, because it's so fine, the steel wool, for about 12 hours, and tomorrow it will be a full-on iron acetate solution. So this is how it's done, and it's going to take a little bit to get it into the bottle. There we go. I don't want to crush it. I want to stay as fluffy as I can with the steel wool, because the more surface area I have, the faster the reaction will occur. So I'm leaving it like cotton candy in there. And you guys know you can always send me a text or message if you have any questions. And what I'll do tomorrow is once these two solutions are made, I'll mix and combine them so that they have the same exact force. And this solution will stay good for quite a long time. Go. Okay, so I have my solutions here. I'm going to give them a bit of a shake now. And that's it. Until tomorrow morning. So I'll see you guys in about 12 hours, which will be about 7:30 tomorrow morning. And you'll see that this will have a full reaction. I'll even grab a piece of Brazilian cherry, which I'm going to apply the iron acetate to, so you can see how fast the reaction is. Until next time, see you guys. Hello everyone, I'm back in my shop, albeit it's actually Saturday in the morning, 11:30. I never made it back yesterday. I spent a lot of time on the road with my crews on job sites preparing everything for when I'm out of town next week, teaching in Guadalajara, Mexico. So we have our part two here, which is the iron acetate solution. Now we had our vinegar and steel wool in it for only 12 hours. I tested it, it was a bit weak. You can see on this side of the board, there's a small 2x2 square, and so it just needed more time. So what I did was I put it out in the sun yesterday and it stayed outside all day. And so now you can actually see it's in full reaction mode. I don't know if you can see it in the video, but there's bubbles inside the bottle, which means the steel wool and the vinegar are reacting. So the iron acetate solution is pretty much at full strength here now. And to test it out again, we're gonna take a little bit of rag, dip it into one of the bottles, and I'm gonna rub it on this white oak right here. Now it just smells like Easter for me because, you know, we color a lot of eggs with the kids over the years. But this is the iron acetate solution as it is now. And you can see the reaction is pretty instantaneous. It starts to get really dark. Now we're actually doing this on a Brazilian cherry sample, and so what I have here is what I call a three-board sample, which is two pieces of Brazilian cherry and two more in the center showing a joint. I always like to show joints on my samples. In any case, I'm going to take the iron acetate and put it on this Brazilian cherry. I'm going to show it to you guys. Let's move this around. going to do it with a foam brush. I'm also going to use a little pot so I can get my iron acetate liquid in there and dip it, my foam brush into it. When this iron acetate solution is used, it looks kind of it looks clear. If you let oxygen get to it, it will start rusting the steel components that are inside the solution. So it doesn't make it bad that it's rusty looking, but it's just something unsightly on older iron acetate finishes. So here we go. Iron acetate on Brazilian cherry. I don't know if you can see it, but from the top of the sample to the bottom sample, it's already starting to turn darker. And you really want to soak it. And as it starts changing color, the iron acetate working, you may want to take a second application to iron acetate. So it's going to take a little time for this to change color. But you can see it's turning. There we go. And my solution of iron acetate can go right back in the bottle. And I'll have plenty of stuff for next time. So as you see, it's taking that Brazilian cherry and turning it to a really nice dark brown color. The iron acetate on the oak is making it nearly black, which is what it should do. All right, if you guys have any questions about this, you know how to get a hold of me. In the meantime, y'all have a good day.